A very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 21st March, on the front page you have Kamal Nath resigns ahead of flow test. BJP set to form government in Madhya Pradesh. So with a strength of 104 MLAs in a truncated house, BJP has a clear majority now because the Congress members have now quit the party. So they have not joined BJP yet. We saw Jyotiraditya Scindia joining, but others have not joined BJP yet. But then the number of members in the house reduces. So BJP easily won the floor test. It has a clear majority. So before the floor test itself, Kamal Nath resigned, Congress Chief Minister of Madhya Pradesh. Then this is singer's COVID-19 status has politicians worried. So we are having Bollywood singer Kanika Kapoor's announcement that she has been tested positive for COVID-19, triggering a scare among several top politicians who had attended a series of events with her in Lucknow recently, as well as those who were in contact with her. Then here you have this graph also of how COVID-19 cases are increasing in India. The cases have crossed 200 mark yesterday. So it says while it took 9 days for the first 50 cases to spread, and then in 5 days 100 cases took place, and here you can see in 3 days it went to 150 and in 2 days 200. So it reached 200 in 2 days, from 150 to 200. So that is the spike being shown. And here you have 4 Nirbhaya convicts hanged to death at dawn. So, death row convicts in the Nirbhaya gang rape and murder case have been hanged to death in Tihar jail. On page 2, you have complete timeline of how they kept on delaying their death penalty. And finally, now they have been hanged on March 20, 2020. On the editorial page, the first editorial is the missing notes. So this says political India should put up a united front against the fast galloping virus. So Prime Minister Narendra Modi in his address to the nation on coronavirus rightly focused on what people should do in what is fast turning into a crisis situation. But then it is said that there was very little by the way of reassurance to the people about what the government was doing or planning to do to mitigate the developing crisis. So the missing points are highlighted here in the address. And this is crime and punishment. So this is how a society that prefers a male child has already condemned its women to an unequal world. So how women, you know, have been condemned, and you know, it's a crime and punishment which has come now after 8 years in the Delhi gang rape case. Then on the lead article here is every man is a part of the male. So this talks about how literature and history show that crisis which levels out the society can be overcome by banding together. So this is in context of coronavirus, that it can help in coming together of all, and it can act as a great leveler, bringing all at the same level. And this is blunting the economic impact of the pandemic. So this talks about how the coronavirus COVID-19 is going to affect the economy, and there are a number of helpful actions the government can take in response to this distress situation across various sectors. So it talks about how cash transfers can be done to assist daily wage earners, loan guarantees can be, you know, provided, and mortgage holidays can be provided, as has been done in foreign countries too. That is highlighted here. Then on Saturdays, you have this ground zero coverage, which is on the front line fighting the coronavirus. So this is regarding how 53 confirmed cases have been found in Maharashtra, which is the highest number of coronavirus cases in India. So doctors, medical officers and microbiologists give their views on how to remain vigilant as the virus continues to spread in the state. On page 12, you have defense procurement draft release. So Ministry of Defense has come up for the first time leasing of defense equipments as a new category of acquisition of in the draft defense procurement policy 2020. So this draft is waiting for the suggestions from industry before it is finalized for promulgation. So it will come into effect from 1st April 2020 and supersede the Defence Procurement Procedure of 2016. And this is Lok Sabha passes Bill on National Importance Tag for IIITs. So these are Indian Institutes of Information Technologies. So they have recorded 100% placement. So now the government wants to give them status of a tag of national importance. So they will become Institution of National Importance, INI. So this is a bill has been passed in Lok Sabha for this. On international page again, you have how cases are rising in US, how Trump blames China for the pandemic. And even G7 meeting would be held through video conference. On business page here, you have regarding how sectors have been affected by coronavirus and how RBI has also put in motion a contingency plan in wake of COVID-19 to ensure that financial markets continue to function smoothly. And this is how poultry industry has suffered, how tourism industry seeking bailout, it has also suffered because of COVID-19. So that is it. These are the important headlines. For detailed coverage of current affairs, you can visit our website, asha.com. Thank you and stay safe.